Let's clap. One, two, ha!
Here with Alvin Waite, who is one of the teachers at Prairie Central Adventist Academy, which is our venue for this year. Welcome, Mr. Waite.
Thank you.
So are you having an opportunity to promote your school?
Yes, I have met with a few individuals, so they have come to ask questions, you know, just to find out more about the school.
And what do you have set up here at your table? Lots of fun going on over here.
Well, yes, we have a few STEM kits that we, you know, kids come and they just try to build a few things.
Awesome. All right, one last question for you. Truth or dare?
Truth.
How is today's event inspiring you to serve your community more?
Well, you know, seeing so many people just come out to socialize with each other, just to take part in the day's activity, it is really inspiring. And I do believe that we need more activities like this in our community, where people can just come and socialize in a friendly environment.
Awesome. Thank you, Mr. Waite.
You're welcome.
I'm here with Johnson. And Johnson, are you from Winnipeg?
Originally, I am from Winnipeg, but I'm living in Alberta now.
All right. So this means this is your first Family Fun Day. Are you enjoying it?
Thoroughly enjoying it. Getting to see a lot of people I haven't seen for a long time and having a good time.
All right. One more question for you. Truth or dare?
Okay. Truth.
How does this event inspire you to serve your community more?
Well, it gets the word out who we are, what we do, and the ultimate is serving God.
Awesome. Thank you, Johnson.
You're welcome. Take care.
Fel, welcome to Family Fun Day. Are you having fun?
Yes, it's absolutely beautiful here. It's a lot of fun, probably a little bit more than I expected, but it's great.
You can never have too much fun. I have a question for you. Truth or dare?
Truth.
Okay, how does today's event, Family Fun Day, inspire you to serve your community more?
I remember saying to some people that, you know, the Fun Day will be moving to PCAA. And they're like, PCAA? And I got the opportunity to say, well, it's for a community impact. One thing that really resonates with me, one thing that I get a lot of fulfillment from is serving. And so seeing the community, seeing us in the community this way, I'm already like thinking of ideas of like, how can we make even a bigger impact in the community from here out? Like, this is a seed planted, but how can we get it to germinate and just flourish into something better?
Awesome. Thanks, Filoni. Enjoy.
Thank you. Have a good one.
I'm here with three awesome friends, Jonna Kay. You can wave. Akira and Jayla. Okay, I have one question for each of you. Very simple. Truth or dare? We'll start over here. Jonna Kay.
Dare.
I dare you to find somebody and give them a compliment. Anybody? Yeah.
I really like your haircut.
Awesome. See? Very simple. Akira, your turn. Truth or dare?
Truth.
How does this event inspire you to serve your community more?
Seeing everybody so happy and like coming together, it makes me want to strive to be a better person who will reunite people. And just seeing the multiple people who are laughing and smiling, it just, you know, inspires me to make everybody happy and try my best to be a better person to make somebody smile.
Okay, Jayla, your turn. Truth or dare?
Dare.
I dare you to find someone and give them a compliment. And we're going to follow you.
I love your hat, Mr. Wade. We're representing the Winnipeg Jets.
All right, I'm here with Stephanie. And Stephanie actually works with ADRA Canada. Stephanie, what do you do with ADRA? What's your role?
Right now, I'm regional manager for Manitoba, Saskatchewan. So my job is to work with the churches to do community projects just like this.
Awesome. And so what are you doing here at your booth today?
Well, today I'm talking to people about ADRA, what we're doing here in Winnipeg, working with the Adventist Community Services Center. So we're doing backpacks for kids going back to school. And then I'm getting volunteers for our kindness project to do Christmas hampers and try and build relationships with people here in the community.
Awesome. So, Stephanie, I have a question for you. A truth or dare question. Which one would you like, truth or dare?
Truth.
How does today's event, Family Fun Day, inspire you to serve your community more?
You know, I love seeing people that I don't know. I love strangers. It's just, you know that we're all part of the family of God, and so I get to meet new people. And there's been a lot of new people here today, so that's been one of my favorite things, is meeting new people.
Awesome. Thank you, Stephanie. All right, I'm here with Zachary and Jason. I have one question for each of you. Okay, ready? Truth or dare?
Truth.
So they both want truth. How does this event inspire you to serve your community more?
Dare.
You want a dare instead? Okay, dare instead. Your dare is to find somebody and give them a compliment.
Okay. That's okay. Easy.
That's easy?
Hey, you look beautiful today.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
And now Jason?
I look beautiful today too. Again.
Pastor Delfred, welcome.
Thank you very much.
Now, it's not raining right now. Why are you soaking wet?
Well, it's raining there.
So yep. You were one of the volunteers for the dunk tank?
Yep, I think 12, 13th time already. Yeah.
I mean, it is a hot day. Is this helping you cool off?
oh, it is a privilege to be there, honestly. But after like the 10th, 11th, it gets a little cold.
All right, well, we hope you warm up soon, but we have a question for you.
Okay.
Truth or dare?
Truth.
How does this event inspire you to serve your community more?
Well, I just met new people here. And we're like, oh, really? Is it okay there? And so, because just because of this, I get to know friends, right? And it's like, oh, we know, it's like, oh, you're from the Philippines, you know? And they're like, oh, we're in the Philippines. And I realized that we're not that far, actually, back home. And so this is an amazing thing that you make friendship and relationship. And, you know, now I've got a phone number and we can meet and, you know, we can, I don't know, maybe eat outside together and visit them and invite them home.
Awesome. Thank you, Pastor Delfred. Oh,
thank you very much.
I'm here with Kiara. Are you having fun today?
Yes.
One question for you, Kiara. Very easy. Truth or dare?
Truth.
How does this event inspire you to serve your community more?
When I see everybody going around and getting prizes and having fun, and also there's some booths that have to do with charity, I just think of, you know, we have so many children in this community, and this is such a great event for them, and I get inspired to do more things that can help children out, because children's ministry is like extremely important, especially since we have a lot of kids in our church. So seeing that this event is like always successful, it makes me want to do more things, especially since I have experience working with children. Like, I worked at a daycare. I feel like children's ministry is important and I would like to do more in it. Yeah.
Awesome. Thanks, Kiara.
You're welcome.
Douglas, my friend, it's good to see you outside of the media room.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Most people don't see us.
That's right. But we appreciate what you do. So thank you.
You're welcome.
Now, I promised you one question and one question only. Truth or dare?
Truth.
How does this event inspire you to serve your community more?
This is beautiful. And I think we've not been doing much of it. And I think we need to do more. To be frank, I did not know we have this much land. When I was driving in, I just realized we have bigger land that we can be able to be using it more and more. We have young people who are energetic, who can be able to, you know, have fun here. And yeah, I feel young now.
You still are. Thank you, Douglas.
You're welcome.
Pastor Ricardo, here we are at the end of Family Fun Day. How was it today?
Oh, I think that it was very successful. I saw a lot of people from our immediate community just to come and join and have fun, lots of kids. It was great. We had the police here joining us and volunteering and showing the car. It was amazing. We had like the rock wall. That was a hit for BVS and now for Family Fun Day. We had a few brave volunteers that wanted to get wet. Pastor Delfred, and I know Rex was there, Martin. I don't know who else, but Abby. Yeah, so it was great. Like, I mean, lots of stuff, lots of food, lots of games, lots of good times. So I don't know. I don't know what else to say. It was a fun day.
All right, and I know I've been taking notes, so we're already planning for next year. So 2025, save the date, last Sunday in August. I have one question for you. Truth or dare?
Truth.
How does this event inspire you to serve your community more?
To be honest with you, I just want to make it bigger. That's kind of, I'm excited for next year. Every time that I see more people from the community just showing up, to me, it tells me that what we are doing is valuable and that we are actually building some connections for eternity. So I enjoyed it. Yes.
Awesome. Thank you, Pastor Ricardo.